Welcome Ramadan. Welcome Ramadan, and this is a special guest which we want to welcome. And for a guest, what we do, we wait, we plan, we want to do best with the guest, doing the nice hospitality and so on and so forth. Nahmaduhu nusalli ala rasulihi al-kareem amma ba'd. Fa'uz billahi min ash-shaytani rajeem. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. So when you welcome the Ramadan, in Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned about the Ramadan in Surah Al-Baqarah, ayat number 183 onwards. And also, it talks about the month of the Ramadan where fasting has been made compulsory. And also, it talks about in this month, the Quran has been revealed. شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن هدى للناس وبينات من الهدى والفرقان فمن شهد منكم الشهر فليصم ومن كان فريدا أو على سفر فعدة من أيام أخر يريد الله بكم اليسر ولا يريد بكم العسر ولا تكملوا عدة ولا تكبروا الله على ما هداكم ولعلكم تشكرون. So the month of Ramadan is that in which Quran was revealed. It's a guidance to the people, clear proof, guidance and criterion. Quran is Furqan. So whoever sides the new moon, the month, let him fast. And whoever is ill or on a journey, then equal number of other days Allah intends for you ease and does not intend for you hardship and wants for you to complete the period and to glorify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for that to which He guided you, and perhaps you will be grateful. So we fast. This is the month of the Quran. So Angel Jibrail in month of Ramadan, he used to recite Quran twice with Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So we should also adopt the sunnah, at least recite once, make it an intention and goal for dues, at least reciting once or twice, make a higher goal, at least achieve, you will achieve one or twice, you will complete it. And in Nazare Quran, now, right now you plan it because this is the month of Quran, this is a month of mercy. So you want to recite the Quran, and Quran was sent in this month from the Lohe Mahfuz, and you can plan like daily you can recite it 1.5 juz or 2 juz, because you're going to miss it during the time of the period, because many people, they ask the question, can I read Nazare Quran in the period, like can I do it from iPad, phone? But that is not the ibadah. That is like, you know, you can do from the workbook, word to word and so on, but for the ibadah, what is prerequisite? Purification. You are not reading Salah, but there is an exception. If you are a hafiza, you are memorizing the Quran, or you are a teacher. But here we are talking about reciting the Quran. But here mention about who are ill and on the journey. They can make the equal number later on. And Allah wants ease. Like, you know, you should do the fasting. If you are very sick and you are on journey, you can make it later on. And in the Shaban, try to do the miss fasting before the Ramadan starts. And Allah says, perhaps you will be grateful in this ayah number 185, Surah Al-Baqarah. Because why you should be grateful? Because Allah wants to be you to be grateful because you did 29 or 30 juz and 30 days of Ramadan. Then what you have to do? Proclaim name of Allah, like, you know, in the Eid time, what we do, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, we recite takbirat because we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the month when we say marhaba Ramadan, we are welcoming Ramadan. Wa yunadi munadi ya baghi al khair aqbilu wa ya baghi al shahr al aqdir. When the month of Ramadan and arise, caller cries out, O seeker of good, proceed, hasten. O seeker of evil, desist. This is in Sunan and Tirmidhi. Things to do fast in the first half month of the Shaban. You can do Ayyam maybe 13, 14 and 15 and Monday and Thursday. After 15th of Shaban, you have to keep your energy safe for the Ramadan. Read nice books, nice lectures, and so on and so forth. Before cleaning your house, cleaning your heart. So for cleaning the heart, you have to remove the filth, remorse, regret, and you know, removing the filth, you have to clear the spam, trash from your heart. Like, you know, hearts have different resentments. It has rancor, it has hasad, and it has a different kind of hatred and backbiting, misunderstanding. You have to remove that so that you can have the taqwa of Allah, fear of Allah. And fear of Allah, when you want to have the fear of Allah, first you have to cleanse your heart. And these are only few number days. Spend most of your time in ibadah and performing good deeds. Minimize the time spent on fulfilling personal needs. Avoid all unimportant, useless things, you know, especially spending a lot of time on gadgets and so on and so forth. And when we say istiqbalu Ramadan, welcome Ramadan with the invocation, because in this it's mentioned, when you cite the new moon of the month of the Ramzan, observe fast. And when you cite it, the new moon of the Shawwal, break it. And if the sky is cloudy for you, then observe fast for 30 days. And when you cite the new moon, you have to recite this dua. Allahumma ahillahu alayna bil yumni wal imani wa salamati wal islami rabbi wa rabbukallah. Oh Allah, let this moon month pass over us with blessing, iman, safety in the state of Islam. Oh moon, my Lord and your Lord is Allah. This is in Sunan Antirmizi. There is another dua also. This is a month of barakah, month of mercy and blessing. Iskana Ramadan futtihat abwaabu rahma. When a month of Ramadan starts, the gates of mercy are open. And we have to avail this opportunity. Ramadan has come, a blessed month. And Allah has made obligatory fasting, because the gates of heaven are open and gates of hellfire are closed, because devils are chained. To Allah belongs a night in which it is better than 1,000 months, means Laylatul Qadr. So whoever is prevented from good, then he has been deprived. This is in Musnad Ahmad. Things to do: hasten in all type of good deeds, worship, helping others, greeting, you know, in the home also greeting salam again and again, because devils are chained. So it is easier to do good deeds, morning, evening, azkar, and you can do the zikr. Ya hayyu ya qayyum bi rahmatika astaghis asli li shani kullahu wa la takilni ila nafsi tarfatain. And this is a month of fasting. Do fasting, because O you who believe, decreed upon you fasting, as it was decreed upon you, those before you, that you may become righteous. Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu kutiba alaykum as-siyama kama kutiba alal ladhina min qablikum la'allakum tattaqun. In another verse, it was mentioned, famin shahida minkum shahra falyasumhu. Whoever cites the new moon, moon of the month, let him fast it. So it is a mandatory. We have to fast. Fasting is a means of entry into Jannah. Abu Umama reported, I came to Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and said, order me to perform a deed that will allow me to enter Jannah. He said, alayka bis saum fa innahu la mislalah. So there is no equivalent to it. There is a special door in Jannah for those who fast. Babu Rayyan, indeed there is a gate of Jannah. Inna fi jannati babu yuqalu lahu Rayyan. And it is called Rayyan. It will be called on the day of judgment. Where are those one who fast? So whoever is among the fasting ones will enter. This is a special entry pass only for the people who are fasting. And the odor of the mouth of fasting person has been appreciated. It doesn't mean like, you know, you keep your mouth untidy. No, you can do the miswak. And if you have doubt, like, you know, using the paste, like, you know, break your fast, many ulama allowed that using the paste. But if you have doubt, use the clean brush without the paste. And fasting is a shield. As-siyamu junna. Fasting is a shield from hellfire. Fasting is a protection from hellfire. And things to do. Fasting is mandatory, like, a small sickness or so on and so forth, or a small journey, 2 hours, 3 hours, do not leave the fasting. Do the fasting because it's easy for you. If you are young and still, pregnant, nursing, but still you have energy to do, go ahead and do it because it's easy for some people. Alhamdulillah. And Allah, there's a hadith, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, man sama ramadana imana wa ihtisaban ghufira lahu ma taqaddama min zambi. Whoever fasts during Ramadan faith and seeking his reward from Allah, Allah will have his past forgiveness. Like, we all want forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah forgive our sins. Ramadan is a shahrul iftar. Do the iftar with the family and suhoor. And this is a barakah in doing the sahri. Even water, few dates, protein, whatever you like, but have. And there are two joys for the fasting person when he breaks it and when he meets his Lord because of the reward. And it is must known to break the fast on time. Don't hasten early, not delay. The fasting should be broken with the plain water or dates. Things to do, practice moderation. When preparing the meals, don't spend hours and hours in iftar. Avoid greasy food. If you have leftover, you can keep in the fridge or freeze it. Invocation for the fast. Zahaba zam'u wa btala'ti uruqu wa thabbata ajru insha'Allah. The thirst has gone and the veins are quenched and the reward is confirmed is Allah's will. Sunan and Abu Dawood. And this is a shahrul ghufran. Forgive the people. If they ask forgiveness or not, then also forgive. And ask istighfar. Do more istighfar. Suratul Najm, ayah number 32. Allazina yajtanibuna kabairal ismi. Those who avoid major sins and immoralities. So indeed, your Lord is vast in forgiveness. And Ramadan ila Ramadan mukaffiratu ma bainahunna iza. One Ramadan expiates the sins till the next Ramadan. So if Alhamdulillah, we are getting the opportunity, make dua to witness the Ramadan and do the fasting and do good. Fasting during the day and praying at the night are source of expiation of the sins. Whoever fasts during the Ramadan out of sincerity, faith and hoping to attain Allah's reward them, all his past sins will be forgiven. من سام رمضان إيمان واحتساب قفر على ما تقدم من ذنبه. Fasting people, Allah will reward us. And this is the month we have to do hasten good deeds and ask forgiveness, do istighfar, cry in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أستغفرالله العظيم الذي لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم وأتوب إليه. Forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is a month of piety. Have taqwa of Allah, fear of Allah, asking people forgiveness and forgive people even though they are not asking it. Adopt virtues like, patience, humility, Allah's consciousness, and keep the good environment at your home. If you know that something your talk may displease your family, so avoid such kind of talk. Allahumma inni as'aluka al-huda wa-tukha wa-lafafa wa-lghina. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for guidance, consciousness, chastity, contentment. And this is the month of sabr. Have the sabr, because not only regarding the fasting, not eating and abstaining from the things like husband wife relationship and food, but also guard your tongue and don't say the things which is ill talk, which make others unhappy. Be in positive. This is Shahrul Quran. Recite more and more Quran. And this is there is a day in which it is thousand months, that is Laylatul Qadr. Recitation of the Quran, recite more and more and listen to Dore Quran. Spend more time in learning, teaching others, involve in the good deeds, do more and more charity. This is the month of the dua. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, beg Allah to forgive us and ask forgiveness for the whole ummah. Things to do, opportunities provided in the month of Ramadan. It's a training period. You have to train yourself, abstaining from the food and drink and the husband-wife relationship. And when you are fasting, don't think that I'm going to lose the weight. No, your intention should to Please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and this is a month of zikr. Do lot of zikr. Allazi yazkuruna Allah qiyama wa qu'udan wa ala junubihim. Like the doing zikr, standing, sitting, you know, that is how a mu'min should be. And doing istighfar more than 100 times. Keep your tongue moist with the istighfar. You should have the apps of the books, Vayaka Nastain, Quranic and Masnoon Dua, Tasbih, Subhanallah, Tahmeed, Alhamdulillah, Takbir, Allahu Akbar, Tahli, La ilaha illallah, Glorification, Tasbih, Subhanallah, wa bihamdihi, Subhanallah, Walhamdulillah, wa La ilaha illallah, Wallahu Akbar. Subhanallah wa bihamdihi adada qalqihi wa rida nafsihi wa zinata arshi midada kalimatihi. Recite more and more ayatul kursi, more and more durood, and do lot of istighfar. Astaghfirullahu al-azim allazi la ilaha illa hu al-hayyul qayyum wa atubu ilayk. And this is the month of mawasat, the month of compassion, and the month of shahrul mawasi, which means that it is a month for human beings to show kindness, be kind to the people, be good to the people, show humbleness, do good to everyone, and join the kingship, call them, have good talk with them, have good relationship with them. Shahrul Sadqa, especially Zakat, you have to take out Zakat. It's a mandatory. If you have, if you don't have money because of this pandemic, you don't have job, you have to sell the gold from the gold you have. And if you have money sitting from more than 1 year, you have to give the zakat for that. And if you have, apart from leaving the home, you have more homes, more than 1, 2, 3, 4, you have to give zakat. Open your heart, spend as much as you can, give more and more charity, spend on the family and on others, give to the poor, give in the masjid. And also, this is a Shahrul Qiyam. Stand in the prayer in the night, especially at the time of the Tahajjud. Make it mandatory on yourself. This is a training period, especially last 10 nights. Try to be awake. If you can't, at least sleep for 30 minutes or 1 hour. Person to person vary. Nourish your body completely. Now take vitamins and nourish your body. Because when you fast, you know, your body will complete cleanse you. It is a cleansing for you. Even non-Muslim, they used to fast. They say fasting is good, and our deen is complete, and you know it is on fitra. When you fast, there are so much benefits when you see biological also, because when you are fasting, except heart, your digestive system is not come to a pause, because when you drink water also, it starts working, and you are giving complete pause to the body. And when you fast for 12 to 14 hours or 10 hours, 8 hours, whatever it may be, and body is taking out all the toxic things from your body. And do the itikaf, and you know, if the masjid allows, you can do over there, and do a lot of charity, and prepare yourself for the Eid. Do the shopping right now. Don't shop like last 10 nights, because that is the time of the dua, Laylatul Qadr, night of decree. You have to spend more time, especially last 10 nights. Allahumma innaka afuwan kariman tuhibbul afwa fa'afuni. Make lot of dua, make lot of charity, ask Allah, beg Allah, especially for the pandemics and especially the people who are going through a lot. Allah, make it easy for everyone. Make dua for everyone. And make sure that you do fasting in a nice manner, and keep good environment at your home. Have good food, eat yourself, and also distribute to others. You can send them, because these days limited allowed in the masjid. So you won't be able to invite more people. At least, you know, limited to people you can invite, and you can send the food. Because if you break the fast for somebody, it is as if you are breaking fast for yourself. Jazakallah khairan kaseera. Do subscribe the channel. Name is Ilm Quran for All.